This is News 3 Evening Edition.
Good evening. I'm Phil Scoggin.
And I'm Teresa Whitaker. Disturbing details are emerging in the Smith Station House of Horrors child abuse case.
Elizabeth White joining us now live from our East Alabama newsroom with new details uncovered in court today. Elizabeth.
It stunk. Like feces.
An overpowering stench of human waste is how investigators describe the smell of Pamela and James Bond's Lee Road 246 home, where investigators allege the couple and their granddaughter locked her 3-year-old girl and 4-year-old boy in cages.
There was feces on the actual wood itself. There was some stains of feces and or urine on the mattress. There was
any insects or bugs?
Yes, sir. There was cockroaches crawling outside of the cribs on the walls, and there were some on the mattress as well.
Investigators were called to the home in January when the cages were reported to DHR by another relative. Investigators say at first, Pamela Bond tried to hide the locks.
I asked her what she was doing, and she told me nothing. And I told her she needed to take the lock that I had just seen on there and put it back where she had just got it from. And she told me that she did that because she didn't want to get in trouble.
James Bond told investigators he constructed the cages because the children, specifically the 4-year-old boy, was destructive.
So that's why they would lock them into the cribs at night, was so that they couldn't get out, and it was for their safety, is what he told us.
Investigators say the situation was anything but safe. The children couldn't stand up in the cages, so they had to lay down in human waste with live bugs. An older child in the home says the children were locked up a lot.
He basically said that it was just a short period of time in the afternoon that they were able to roam freely.
Ms. Bond, Mr. Bond, do y'all have anything to say about the charges levied against you? No comment at all right now.
The Bonds did not comment after leaving court when a judge decided to send their case to a grand jury. The children's mother, 30-year-old Kyla Mann, remains behind bars trying to make a bond. All three face aggravated child abuse and reckless endangerment charges.
Investigators say in all there were 5 children living inside that Smith Station home, ages 8 months to 10 years old. They have all been removed and are in the protective custody of DHR, living with foster families. Of course, Phil, Teresa, we'll keep you updated as this case evolves. Back to you. All right. Thank you, Elizabeth.